It's now time for Inside Dr. Herman's Head with Dr. Jan Herman and Greg Big Show Larson. To reach Dr. Herman, call 570-420-9670. And now, Dr. Herman. There it is.
There is what? You messed up our opening song.
I don't give
a... You better behave, or this will be your last show.
That's... don't threaten me.
Welcome to Inside Dr. Herman's Head on this beautiful first day of October, the year 20,000.
That's right, it is.
2017. Yes, it's October. The summer has passed you by. You missed it.
No way. This is my time.
I am Dr. Jan B. Herman of Herman Family Chiropractic Center. I'm here with Jan B. Herman, Jan B. Quick. That's me. I'm here with Greg Big Show Larson.
Yeah.
The big show of the big shows.
Yes, yes.
And I'm also here with, we're here with Melinda Koehler tonight.
Melinda.
Melinda, one of our favorite guests, who's I think has the record for appearances on our show.
Probably, yeah.
Ooh, right? I get an award.
She's been here like 50 times.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, no. Seriously, thank you for coming in. We love to have you.
Anytime.
Okay. Yes, it is October 1st.
Yeah.
So I would like to say happy birthday. To all the original Cabbage Patch dolls.
Oh man, I had one. I had one.
Did you?
Yeah. I just
a boy or a girl?
It was a boy.
Uh huh.
I did. Come on, man. I was a dude. I wasn't gonna have a girl.
No, that's okay. Boys gonna play with dolls.
I had a boy too. That was the only thing my parents could get.
You see that? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. It was the only one I could get because you had to wait. We waited months, and then finally the store was like, "Hey, come down. There's three."
Well, you
had to just choose. You couldn't be like, I want a bald baby or whatever. That's
whatever you grabbed.
So I had this dude with like a yellow afro, and his name was the yellow curly hair, and his name was Bartholomew, and I was like,
that's a very typical Cabbage Patch Boys.
I don't want that.
Well, come on.
Whatever. He was all right for the time being.
Do you still have him?
No.
No.
Why not?
I don't know. I wish I did. Actually, I don't know what happened to him. You know what's going to happen? My dad's going to call in and tell you what happened to him.
Oh, I'm sure.
I threw him out. You said you didn't want him, and I threw him out. That's what he said happened to my He-Man guy. I want dad. I didn't want the Cabbage Patch Kid.
Have we opened up a wound or what?
I asked you, and you said you didn't care. So
So I drove the car over it a few times, and then threw it away.
Exactly.
Melinda, you still have yours?
Yes.
What was his name?
Lyle Sid.
Oh, my God.
She remembers the middle name.
Lyle Sid.
Do you remember that the birthdays were all October 1st?
No, I don't remember that, but I do remember the birth certificate.
Yes.
You had to the birth certificate,
yeah.
It came from Babyland General Hospital. And they originally had said that they were all October 1st birthdays because that's the birthday of the owner, the creator, Xavier Roberts.
Xavier Roberts, yeah.
Yeah. But he actually, his birthday, I believe, is on Halloween, on October 31st.
Ah.
Yeah, so...
Hey, I like the Garbage Pail Kids. Those were my dudes.
They were, because it was... Right, I know. You can collect them all.
Yep.
I'll tell you a story, my very bizarre story with Cabbage Patch Dolls. It was like 1983. And they were as... That was the height.
The
height of the craze. And I worked for my father in his store in Brooklyn, in Brighton Beach. And the next block was a toy store. And my dad knew the toy store owner very well. They were friends for many years. And I said, I knew him, because I was working in my dad's store a lot. So I went in and I said to him, I don't remember his first name now, but it was years ago. I said, do you have any of the Cabbage Patch dolls? And he said, we don't have any now, but we're expecting a delivery at the end of the week. I said, when? He says, well, Saturday. I said, well, I'll be here Saturday. So he says, well, I'll let you know. And it took down, he said, I'll call you at the store.
Yeah.
Came Saturday morning, and I went to work, and sure enough, he called the store at like 7:30 in the morning, and he said, we have a shipment. We just got in like 40 of them.
Oh wow,
that's a good shipment.
He said, so we're putting them out on the shelves now. The store doesn't open for another half an hour. If you want, come right now.
Oh, my gosh.
So I drove. I had to go make a delivery, and I had just gotten my license just maybe a few months before that. My girlfriend, who eventually became my practice wife, she... was very, very orange-haired and very, very green-eyed. So she wanted one for the holidays, and this was like around Thanksgiving time, so it was very hard to get. I said to him, how much would you charge me for this doll? And he says, I'll let you have it for half the price of what I'm selling them.
Wow. What?
I said, that was really, really nice. Wow. So it was only $100.
Only $100.
Only $100.
But whatever.
Okay?
Yeah, that's...
$100. And I was you know, I was a kid. I didn't have a lot of money. I was, you know, so anyway, so I had to go make a delivery for the store. So I took, I said on the way back, I'm going to, the delivery was a couple of blocks away. I made my delivery, and on the way back, I was going to stop by, and I had to triple park.
Oh, man.
There was no parking space.
Wow.
I ran in. I said, this is only going to take me a minute or two. I can definitely get out in time. And I ran in, and he had them all laid out on the shelf, and there was one that looked exactly like her.
That's creepy.
The freckles, the red hair, the green eyes.
Wow.
Okay? And I said, this is the one I want. This is great. So I paid for it, and I went outside and grabbed the ticket off the windshield of the car. And then jumped in the car, cursed the world, and then went back to the store. So the doll cost me $160.
Oh. Hey, whatever, man.
Other people were paying $200
or more.
You got the more,
so. And got the one you wanted. That's the thing.
Right?
Like, so lucky.
I mean, years later, I had to buy two Furbies, two kids, and two of everything else. So welcome to Inside Dr. Herman's Head. Who's calling?
Hello, Dr. Jan.
Hello, Robert.
I know it.
Yes.
What's up? You have a story.
Greg did say he didn't want it, and yes, I did throw him out.
You probably asked him while he was playing a video game and he couldn't be pulled away or something.
No, and besides that, I do still have the birth certificate.
You do?
Yes, I do.
You wouldn't happen to know, like, is it accessible to you right now?
Pardon?
Do you know where it is right now?
Yeah, downstairs.
Okay, if you have to check it, I'll bet you it's October 1st.
Well, I don't know.
It was later on when they started putting different dates on them. But in the beginning, for the first couple of years, they were all October 1st.
I got it. Yeah, well, I got it, like, just like you said, like right when they were coming out, right when they were hot. So
yeah,
I had to wait, you know. But yeah, what was his middle name? I think he was like Bartholomew James or something. I'm surprised I never called him BJ. You know, that's it. That would have been better than Bartholomew.
Definitely. And you could have got him a little bear, BJ and the bear. Would have been
BJ
perfect. Right.
Right.
Right. Okay, well, we believe me, nobody here was going to blame you, Bob.
I know.
No, okay. He,
for the death of Bartholomew.
All of his items, I asked him before we moved
I
here.
I swear to God.
But it's interesting.
I don't want them.
It's interesting that you kept the paperwork, but you got rid of the doll.
No, the Cabbage Patch is one thing. The He-Man guys, oh.
Well, I know.
Don't forget She-Ra.
She was there, too.
You know he has She-Ra.
Yeah.
I
have the system.
Well, thanks for calling, Bob. I appreciate it.
Okay.
So have a good night. You have what?
You had to have the sister.
Yeah.
To say, I know.
Yeah, Shira's He-Man's sister.
There were too many. I didn't get into that because there were too many dolls. I have a cousin who had all the Star Trek stuff, everything you could possibly buy. And every day she would arrange everything on her bed. It took a half an hour. All the paperbacks, all the books, all the schematics of all the ships, all the figurines.
See, that's ultra nerd right there.
Really crazy. Really crazy. So I got her that doll. And just 2 days ago, because my practice wife passed away, I was over at the house cleaning out some of the things in the bedroom, and I found the doll.
Oh.
The doll is sitting up on the counter with the other dolls, and I don't know where the paperwork is for it. Obviously, we don't have the box anymore, but I wonder if there's any... there's probably no market. I'm finding out as I'm trying to sell some of her stuff that there's no market for anything you think there's a market for.
It depends. What do you...
There's some antique furniture. There's some...
Yeah,
stuff
like that. No, I mean...
She had thousands, literally, of pieces of clothing, hanging clothing, jeans and tops and shirts. Some of them still with tags on them.
Wow.
Brand name stuff. Never used.
Yeah.
And I took them down and I brought them to some of these stores that sell, you know, gently used, you know, whatever. And they... I had 1,000 pieces in my truck, all sorted out in different boxes, jeans and tops and coats and sweaters. And I went to 8 stores. I sold 4 pieces for a total of $17.50.
That's nothing.
I used $80 in gas. I sold my record collection last week, 600 albums for $40.
You know what?
I spent $70 on the crates.
And the worst part is if you would have told me you were accepting something like that, I would have paid you more for all of them.
Wow.
I didn't think that was going to happen.
Oh.
I don't need to hear that now. Thank you.
I would have gave you 60. No, but seriously, I mean, he took 40.
Well, I have no idea what records are worth. You saw what the records were. I let you pick through a few of them. First, you took a dozen of them.
Well,
but
I'll tell you what, right now, there's at least like 5 in there that are going to go for like $30 a piece.
I mean, I assume that he wasn't going to cheat me. So
no,
he's a good guy. We both know him for years. So I assume that he's going to be cool. Whatever.
Most of them will hit that, like I said, $3 bin.
Whatever. You can't spend your whole life regretting what you didn't get from something you don't have.
No, not at all. Especially when you don't care and you don't use it and you don't, you know.
Because everything you have can be gone the next minute anyway.
That's right.
Exactly. Speaking of which, I don't know if you know this. I don't think Melinda knows it, but I don't think you remember this. About 4 years ago, my wife Terry went on a weekend trip with her girlfriends to Florida. It was a long weekend. We had Monday off for some holiday. It was in January, so it could have been Martin Luther King's birthday or something. I don't know, whatever. And I had chosen to close that Monday. So I had a four-day weekend also. So I'm trying to think, what should I do for these 4 days? And I decided to buy a ticket and a return ticket, a round-trip ticket. That's what they call it. what the hell am I doing?
I actually wanted to come back
to Puerto Rico.
Ooh.
Oh, nice.
And I had absolutely no plans otherwise. I took a backpack with enough clothes to change for a day or two or three, whatever I'm going for. And all I had when I got off the plane was a ticket to return. I had to be back at San Juan Airport at that day at that time.
Yeah. Wow.
I walked across the street from the airport, and I went to the first car rental place I could find, and I rented a car. And my plan was to visit every single beach on the island of Puerto Rico in 3.5 days.
Holy cow.
And I had no hotel reservation. I had no idea where I was going to be. I just wanted to stop. And if it was, depending on if I liked it, where it was, how dangerous it was to get to it, whatever, I spent anywhere between 30 seconds and maybe an hour on each beach.
Just like got there, looked at it. All right, let's move.
Yeah, so if it was a small beach and nothing to see or whatever, depending on what was happening there.
Yeah.
I spent an hour on a beach where there was a guy who was windsurfing with his dog.
He went up
in the air with this like giant thing. I'm sorry, not windsurfing, parasailing. Right? Parasailing is where you go up in a parachute, you're being dragged by a boat.
Yeah. Okay.
No, this guy was
windsurfing. He was on a surfboard with sail.
Yes, all right, windsurfing.
There you go.
With his dog.
That's awesome, yeah.
He had the dog strapped to his chest, and the dog, they were 50 feet up in the air. I couldn't believe it. And the dog was loving it.
Yeah.
I watched that for a while. But anyway, so I just kept driving. And my intent was to actually, because I had a small sleeping bag with me, to sleep on the beach. And when I told the guy in the car rental place what I was going to do, he says, "Oh, please, mister, don't sleep on the beach. You don't want to do that." He says, "You got a ticket to come back." He says, "Why would you not want to use your ticket?"
He's honest. So,
and I said, "Really? You think so?" He says, "Man," he says, "you look like a nice guy." He says, "Once you get to the southern half of the island, ain't nobody there speaking any English."
He says,
"and you're not going to come back." He says, "they're going to take all your money, all your clothes, both of your kidneys, and they're going to leave you watching the sunset as you die.
You're going to wake up in a hotel bathtub full of ice."
Exactly. No, they'll just bury you up to your neck with no kidneys and watch. You can watch the everything slip away. So I said, you know what? Maybe that's a good idea. So I started driving. I went east from San Juan, and I went to I ate in 3.5 days some of the most incredible street food.
Oh, I bet.
I wandered in and out of at least 5 or 6 festivals. I don't know what, because they had the day off there also for some festival on Monday. And they were, you know, they had all these street fairs and everything, and they had all the trucks were at, the food trucks.
Yeah.
I had incredible food. I had stuff I'd never heard of before, stuff I couldn't pronounce. Incredible, incredible food. I said, whatever the craziest thing is you have, that's what I want. You know, and literally, if you divide the island in half, the northern half, everybody speaks English and Spanish. In the southern half, nobody speaks English.
Yeah.
It's you know, Spanish. That's it. But what happened was the first night that I stopped, I ended up stopping because San Juan is pretty much in the northeast of the island. Okay. So the first night I stopped in the southeast, the next night I stopped in the southwest, then in the northwest, and then I went back to the airport. But in the southeast, I stopped in a town called Yabucoa, a very small, really, really nice little town. It was my last stop of the night. I watched the sun go down over the mountains, And then it was about 3 o'clock in the morning when I decided to stop going to beaches, because I went to some of them at night also.
Mm-hmm.
They even have a really nice lighthouse there. And then I decided, okay, I was getting tired. It was 3:30 in the morning, and I found a hotel, which I couldn't find on GPS or anything. I had to actually, I found an all-night sub shop. I got a sandwich, and I asked them, where can I get a hotel? And they said, and I had to use my best Spanish, because there was no English. I said, ¿dónde está el hotel? And the guy's like, ¿qué? And I'm like, this is the best I got, dude. Just tell me what it is. I said, sleep, you know, dormo. So he told me where it was. He gave me directions in Spanish, and I actually found the place at the bottom of a hill on the beach.
Huh.
I actually had to knock on the door. There was no answer because it was 3:30 in the morning.
Yeah,
and then
yeah,
I found around the corner the guy was actually washing his car at night.
3 in the morning.
So I said I needed a room. He gave me a room. I went to sleep. Beautiful little town. In the morning, I got going. I watched the sunrise, and then I walked on the beach, and I got going. The reason I bring it up is that Yabucoa is where Hurricane Maria hit land.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
Then it went up to Fajardo, which is the first place I've ever went in Puerto Rico, and I was 8 years old on a vacation with my parents. But Yabucoa got destroyed. Destroyed, and I felt really, really bad. But the whole point is because the show is not all about bad stuff. There actually was this really, really nice story that came out of the hurricane. I don't know if you saw this. In Yabucoa, there was a nursing home, 11 residents, and one lady taking care of them all. And when ABC News went down and interviewed her, she said, they're all going to die. We have no generator, no more diesel for a generator.
Yeah.
We can't let them die. And I felt really bad, especially because I had been there. I knew exactly where this was. It's like a place nobody in America has heard of. And in a place of Puerto Rico where nobody knows where it is.
Right.
The president doesn't even know it's an island.
Gotcha.
So, you know. So anyway, so this guy, his name is... shut up. Okay. He's a CEO. I'll get his name in a second. He's a CEO. Okay, here it is. His name is Eyal Lalo.
All right.
Eyal Lalo, and he's the CEO of Invicta Watch Company.
Ooh.
In Florida. And apparently the guy's got bucks.
Yeah.
And he saw the interview on TV, and he personally loaded up his private plane with like $15,000 worth of stuff that nursing home residents would need.
Aww.
From food to diapers to water to diesel, you know, whatever. And then he flew it down and then had it trucked down to Yabucoa just for this nursing home.
Aww.
And they showed when he was there, when he went up and he introduced himself, and the woman was like, who are you?
Yeah.
And he says, I have $15,000 worth of stuff. I have it just for you people. And she lost it. She really got very, very emotional.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Yeah.
And I was really, really happy to see it. It really, really played nicely.
A few celebrities have been sending their planes down there, too, to get people out that need to go.
Believe me,
you know,
a lot more than the government is doing.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
But the one thing, and again, I know that you both know this about me, I'm not the most particularly religious person in the world. This woman stood in front of the guy. She dropped to her knees. She's crying. And all she's doing is thanking God.
Yeah.
Yep. Thank God. And the man standing right there, he just put $15,000 worth of stuff on his plane.
But he's there because God brought him there. God brought him there.
Yeah. That's what she's thinking.
Come on now. You know that's what they're thinking.
Yeah. What if he doesn't believe in God? What if he's an atheist and he just did it out of the goodness of his heart?
Well, then maybe he should just turn around and pack it all up. I don't know, man. What do you want to, you know?
I just want to understand. I want to understand the mentality.
This is something we will never understand. This is why it's the age-old argument.
I.
Her prayers were answered.
There you go.
Her prayers were answered.
Okay, you know what? Let's take a break for a minute, and then we're going to come back and talk a bit more about prayers.
The hometown advantage. It's up and down Main Street. It's also in the office downtown, the factory by the river, and the farm down the road. That's because most folks who work here love living here. They care about this community. They work hard to succeed, and that makes a difference. At PoconosHelpWanted.com, we're proud to work our hometown advantage around the clock, connecting local employers to local job seekers. Post your job today on PoconosHelpWanted.com. Local jobs that work. The hometown advantage. You see it in the shops and offices downtown, in our factories, schools, and farms. Jeff the accountant has it. So do Corey in IT and Amber, the vet tech. They found local jobs at PoconosHelpWanted.com. It's where local employers find local workers like you, people who care about this community. Search jobs and apply online right now. Get the advantage of finding a job close to home at PoconosHelpWanted.com. Local jobs that work.
I admitted I was powerless over my addiction, that my life had become unmanageable. I had tried to quit on my own, but it never worked.
I was searching for an answer when I reached out and found Narcotics Anonymous. I came to my first NA meeting in defeat and didn't know what to expect.
Surrounded by fellow addicts, I realized I was not alone. I heard them talk about the same feelings I was afraid to share. Recovery is what happens in NA meetings.
It didn't matter what drug or how much I used. In Narcotics Anonymous, I learned it is possible to stop using drugs. I don't have to do it alone.
Call Narcotics Anonymous. We can help. 570-421-6618.
Pocono 96.7.
You're listening to Inside Dr. Herman's Head every Sunday night starting at 7 o'clock right here on Pocono 96.7. And now, back to the good doctor.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Absolutely. Please, don't forget to flip the switch or this will be your last show.
It's here. I said, do not threaten me.
I'm telling you, man, you watch it. This will be the last show you ever do on this station.
Be. I'm going to walk.
You're hobbling, man. Inside Dr. Herman's Head is brought to you by Thai Orchid. If you're looking for a really fresh, 100% authentic, true flavors of Thailand, just make a trip down to Thai Orchid in Stroudsburg on 30 North 9th Street, which is Route 611. It's on the corner of Sarah Street. And don't be scared by curries. Every time I go in there, I hear somebody say, oh, I'm afraid of curries. I don't like it hot or whatever.
Yeah,
first of
it's
all,
hot. Yeah, they don't know.
Curry means different things in different kinds of cuisine.
A lot of the curry I like is all savory stuff. It's not even hot.
Right. Well, you know what? The funny thing is, a lot of people think Indian curry when they think curry.
Of course. Well, yeah, I give them that.
But do you know that Indian curry is not even Indian?
Well, that's
awesome. It's British.
Oh, yeah.
They take all those dried, powdered spices, and they put them all together, and they make a curry. It's not something you would ever find in India.
Oh.
Yeah, it's true.
I never knew that.
And actually, every time I've been they live off of the stuff over in England, too, so... Yeah, that makes sense.
Well, they love it. Have a curry.
Yep.
But no, Thai curries are actually fresh ingredients, not dried and powdered, and they're cooked very quickly. And the heat can be almost nothing to blow your face off. But
the face melter.
The face melter. There's got to be a wrestler in the face melter.
No. Jack Black, when he's in Tenacious D, plays face melting solos. He rips face melting solos on the guitar.
I thought he was, of course, he was Cuba Libre.
Huh?
Cuba Libre? Is that his
Nacho
name?
Libre?
Nacho Libre?
No, but
Cuba Libre, that's a drink.
No,
Nacho Libre?
Tenacious D.
I can't stand Tenacious D.
I can't watch it. Love him.
Can I go back to this religion thing for a second?
Let's do it.
Okay.
Let's ruin our mood.
Do either one of you watch America's Got Talent?
No.
Never.
Okay. I've been watching that show lately. Now, this kid just won. Her name is Darcy Lynn Farmer. She's a 12-year-old out of Oklahoma. And she's in 12 seasons, she's the third child to win.
Oh.
The third girl to win.
Oh.
And the third ventriloquist to win.
Ah.
25% of their number one, winners have been ventriloquists.
Jeff Dunham's bringing them out, man.
When the hell did this come back?
Jeff Dunham.
Yeah, Jeff Dunham is a big...
He's huge.
The guy who won their second season, Terry Fader, is the number one ticket in Vegas now.
Wow.
Yeah. No, that stuff, as soon as Jeff Dunham came out, man, people, got all about it.
So, you know what? Jeff Dunham and Larry the Cable Guy, same thing to me.
No, I agree. I don't... I'm not...
Kind of hokey. And
I'll do Jeff Dunham over Larry, though.
Really?
It is hokey. Yeah, I'll do Jeff
Dunham
over Larry.
Yeah, I guess, because he changes
guy.
The character at least.
Yeah.
Because they can get her done.
But Melinda's a big Larry the Cable Guy fan, I guess, over here.
Actually, I'd rather do Raymond the Amish comic.
Raymond, I ain't talking about a local boy.
He can be very funny, actually. but then the thing I want to talk about in America's Got Talent, and I don't understand religion.
Okay.
I don't understand some of the things about it. Okay, and this is what, maybe you can enlighten me. So this little girl, 12-year-old Darcy Lynn, she won, and she said that she prayed every night to God. She comes from a very religious family, Oklahoma. She prayed every night that she would win America's Got Talent, and she won.
Yeah, she won, yeah.
Now I'm wondering how prayers stack up, how they are valued, okay, by God. Because obviously God answered her prayer. Now, I know that the 3.5 million people that lived in Puerto Rico, who are all pretty religious as far
as
I know.
Pretty Christian community, I think.
They prayed also.
Okay.
They prayed for the non-destruction of their home and their island. That didn't work out. They prayed for help, but that's not working out very well.
Well, what about biblical times when everything got destroyed? I bet they prayed too.
They prayed too. So I'm wondering, if all these people's prayers were, was God just watching America's Got Talent?
He might be a big fan.
And he's like, he fell asleep after granting her prayer and forgot about the people of the Caribbean?
He might be a big fan, man. Reality TV is taking everybody over.
That is questionable. I agree with you.
I want to know how it is that the prayers, which prayers get answered and which ones don't.
I don't know that anyone can answer that.
It's like
the Tootsie Roll pop of religious questions. The world may never know.
How many prayers does it take to save an island? One, two, a whole lot.
The world may never know.
Another thing on America's Got Talent, which I don't understand, and please explain this to me. There was a deaf girl on there.
Okay.
She made it into the finals.
Okay.
She was a singer. She had a hearing, and she lost her hearing. Okay. She was phenomenal. She was an incredible, incredible singer. She was pitch perfect. She was a beautiful singer, incredible voice.
That's awesome. Wow. Okay. That's unique.
She didn't win. Okay. The 12-year-old with her hand up a rabbit's butt that she won.
But she had God on her side. That was the difference.
She had God. Yeah, I guess so. Because God took the other one's hearing away.
God loves puppets. We never knew that, but now we do.
God's a think about what you just said. Yeah, that's another whole show. No. What did it work? We could do another show about that.
Why do you think in Sunday school they're always about puppet shows?
You're right.
Thinking. We have puppets everywhere.
So this girl came on, and ever since the initial audition, okay, because she's deaf, everybody in the audience, instead of applauding, okay, after she sang, they did the deaf applause. You know what deaf applause is?
No.
It's when you do this. You put your hands up and you shake.
Jazz hands
up in the air. That's applauding for deaf people.
But I
want to know something. Wait. Why did they need a different way to applaud? When they see somebody
going like that,
doing that, don't they know what that means?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that makes no sense.
We need something that doesn't make any noise. You can't hear it anyway.
I can understand if you're like telling a story or something, you're using sign language and just really quick to go like that. It means, and then there was a round of applause. But for a whole crowd of people,
it doesn't even matter. You're in the middle of the story.
Like this,
that's applause.
Maybe it means something else in sign language. I don't know. Maybe that means like, man, you really sucked. I don't know. Like,
that's a really good point. That makes sense. Maybe if you do jazz hands down, that means just, I don't know.
Maybe it was like,
that's true.
Should we clap what she's done? Oh, no. You don't know?
That's terrible.
No.
That's like, give it to the finger. That's,
jazz hands only, please.
That means don't vote for her. All right. I'll give you that.
All right. Yeah.
Now, here's another thing that was interesting that came out of that show. The second person, the second place, okay, the runner-up, was a 10-year-old girl. Okay, absolutely phenomenal. She had a voice 10 times better than anybody else. I really thought she was going to win when it came down to the two of them, her and the make believe. I don't know, whatever. I have ventriloquist freak me out. But this 10-year-old girl, okay, wonderful, powerful voice. She's going to be a real superstar in another 6, 7, 8 years. She's going to be, you're going to hear about her. Her name is Angelica Hale. But in any event, she, her family is Filipino.
Okay.
Now, oh, can I digress? Why is Filipino spelled with a P or an F, depending on what you're saying?
Isn't it a PH?
The country is called the Philippines with a PH.
Yeah, with a PH.
But if the person is Filipino with an F.
It could be with an F, yeah. I've seen that.
Yeah, okay, so, right. And they, you know, whatever. Okay.
Yeah, I don't care.
In any event, when I looked up information about these two, now this little girl, she's 10 years old. She was born in America. Okay. They refer to her as a 10-year-old Filipino-American singer.
No, she's born in America.
She's a 10-year-old American singer, right?
Right. She's American.
Right. Just because her parents were born in the Philippines doesn't make her a Filipino-American.
Well, then what about all the African-Americans we got?
They're not African-Americans. We've talked about this.
I know we've talked about it, but they're still calling them that.
They could call them...
So that's, you know, that's why. It's just another separation but when
I looked up, Okay. When I looked up the girl that won the ventriloquist, all right, they said that she's a 12-year-old American ventriloquist.
Right.
But I'm sure her ancestors came from some other country.
Sure.
Oh, but she was little ventriloquist white girl, though. It's just another degree of separation, man.
Keep us apart. Keep
That's
us
it.
Right.
That's what
right.
I'm saying.
It's another reason to hate the guy next door.
That's it.
So her neighbors can hate her because she's Filipino-American.
She's Filipino-American, yeah.
If she would just say she's American, she'd be safe. She's
still born here and probably in the same hospital
as the other people next door, right?
Yeah,
you're right.
You know,
you're right.
But just another thing to separate us.
Like I said, people come from all over to help in times of need and from all over to protest in other times.
Oh, yeah.
Went to Dunkin' Donuts the other day.
Again?
Yeah, well, Danielle was working and she asked me. I said I was going to come by and visit. So she's working at Thai Orchid.
Sure.
So she said, could you pick up a large black coffee for me over at Dunkin' Donuts? And I said, sure.
Nice. Good job, Danielle. I know she used to drink all those big sugary things.
Yeah, she's doing just because she's in competition
next week.
That's next week, big competition. Go, Danielle.
Then it's Oreo time.
Oh, big time. apple pie Oreo.
Yeah,
she's got it. And we decided yesterday we're going to deep fry them.
Oh, come on.
Deep fried apple pie Oreos.
Don't tell me this crap.
So I picked up the coffee for her. And I said to the lady at the window, I said, do you still have that special for AARP members where you get a free donut with a large hot drink? And she said, yes, we do. Now, I don't need it, but why shouldn't I get it?
Sure.
So I said, because they have those really good croissant donuts. Have you had them?
No.
Oh.
Fancy.
You got to get a croissant donut over at Dunkin' Donuts.
What does it look like?
It looks like a cruller, actually.
Oh.
But it's got a totally different taste and texture.
Okay.
Yeah, you'll never eat another thing again.
All right.
Fruits, vegetables, all out the window. Yeah. It's the only thing you'll ever eat. I have a steady diet of croissant donuts from DD. So, but they didn't have any. They were out of them.
Oh.
Expectedly so, because they have these strawberry or blueberry, and they go very quickly.
Ooh.
So I said, can I get they give me Boston cream. My second favorite.
Oh, yeah.
My classic favorite.
Okay.
So the one thing that I said I was going to have, one of two things I said I was going to have after 4 years of no carbs.
Yes, yes.
A Boston cream Dunkin' Donuts and Nathan's French fries.
The one thing you will dumpster dive for.
Yes. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
I know,
so
shut up.
Shut up.
I've known you for a while now.
Oh, God, I will. I don't care if there's two bites sticking out of it. One for each end.
Oh,
So the woman said, okay, so she handed me a bag. And I put it on the seat next to me, and I brought the coffee to Danielle.
Okay.
And I ate something in Thai Orchid while I was there. I had some lunch. And then later on, I went back to my office. I took the bag. I brought it in. About an hour later, I said, oh, I got a donut. I'm going to get my donut. I opened it up, and the woman, usually they'll put at least a piece of paper.
Yeah.
You know, the donut paper?
Sure.
There was no paper.
Because they grab it with the paper.
Yeah, and then they put the paper in the bag with the donut.
Right.
Because they don't want to put their hands on it.
Right.
So if there was no paper in the bag, I don't know if she put her hand on it or whatever, but there was no paper.
How about a napkin?
There was no napkin.
Oh.
And the donut?
Wasn't your...
Wasn't Boston cream.
What was it?
Was it jelly?
It was a hot day. And it was face down in the bag.
So you lost all your icing.
Son of a bitch. This woman put my donut face down in the bag.
Oh, jeez.
When I took it out,
aww,
that was no Boston. Just cream.
Just cream, yeah.
Just cream. All the chocolate. I had a chocolate bag and a cream donut.
Aww.
Do you know how hard it is to disassemble that bag carefully along the glue lines? So you can get it flat enough so you can get all the chocolate off and get it back on top of that donut? I put 20 minutes into the reconstruction of the outside of that donut.
You're crazy. You're crazy.
And when I ate that donut, it tasted that much better.
Because it was free. That's why.
It was free.
At that point, I forgot about the fact that it was free.
Because it was free.
Oh, you're going to tell me about like my principal?
You got it because it was free.
That's terrible. You're talking about my principal.
Yes.
Actually, you know something? You say I have no technique.
No technique. It depends.
Do you know about this?
I don't know.
He's got no technique. Like,
with what?
With stupid stuff, like putting ketchup on a sandwich or something like that. He's like, why's it got to get all over the place? Like, you got no technique.
Does he not know how to open a ketchup packet or what?
Right. Or a bottle, because that's what we were talking about. He doesn't know how to use a condiment bottle. What's the other thing?
Hey there, Jackson. Today I squeezed a Heinz mustard bottle, and the liquid came out of it.
Facing up or facing down?
It was an upside down one.
Oh, okay.
And the liquid came out. It's supposed to avoid doing that reason.
No, never.
So no, you always shake it.
You shake it up, and then always. You open it, and on a napkin you go squeeze, and just get a little bit of that water out, and then you can squeeze it.
Technique.
Melinda, with the technique.
Well, yeah, because you're how old now? Come on now. I learned that when I was young.
And the other thing was this. He believes that that 100% of people must drip gas on their car every time they put gas in the
tank. Gas on your car?
No, you stop it! Did the two of you get it together before the show?
No!
I told him,
you got to do it like a wine bottle, man. You got to roll it off and twist and get that last drop off.
Yeah.
And then that's it.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Well,
you don't get
in answer to your question, I'm 54 years old.
No technique.
And it wasn't until after I turned 54 that this joker told me how to fill up the gas in my car. And I want you to know something. Big show. Big man with the big ideas.
It worked for you?
There hasn't been a single time since you said that I've dripped gas on my car.
See? So I helped.
It's happened every time I gas my car up from the age of 17 to 54. For 37 years, I've been destroying the paint on every car I ever owned. And now I roll it, and it never drips once. And
No, don't curse me.
The heavens every time it happens.
That just made my day because I've helped.
Now.
I've helped.
Yeah,
I've done my job.
You have a purpose on earth.
Yes.
Yeah,
there's nothing worse than dripping. And it's like, oh, where are the paper towels? We got to get it off.
Yeah, you run around. I would just take the, after I put the gas cap on, obviously, I take the windshield washer squeegee and I clean the side of the car
with
it.
Sometimes it's dirty and it's, at least I'm
rinsing off the gas.
I've taken my clothing because I haven't found a piece of towel or something. You do not want that on your car.
You wiped off gas with your clothing?
Oh, yeah. Well, at least you can wash that in the washer.
Yeah, you but go. You're flammable for the rest of the day. People say, Melinda, you stink.
Melinda's huffing. She's huffing, that's why.
No,
sniffing her shirt all day.
No, that's a rarity. But if you don't have a paper towel or something laying around because you had a slight boo-boo.
I like the gas station to give you a glove to wear or they give you some paper towels over there.
Yeah.
Over by Giant.
Yeah,
they have the gloves.
Yeah, they know. They know that people like me are going to, you know. But you know what? I noticed something the other day. Sometimes I don't fill my tank up. Sometimes I put $10, $20, $40 now with the price of gas, and I maybe get half a tank on my Suburban.
Yeah.
Okay. It holds 33 gallons of gas. Holy so God. I've actually spent as much as $140 to fill it up. But if I go over and I say, I'll take $20, whatever, okay, then I go back out to the car, and I fix the handle up so it I don't have to hold it, right? And it starts gassing up. It's set to stop and do what I call the gas. What did I call it? I even wrote it down. I call it the gas pump slowdown. Okay,
yes. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
About somewhere in the last, you know, whatever, before it hits the $20 or the $30, whatever you put in the set of that, it slows down.
It's like the last 50 cents or so.
It's going to be. I went to a place. I've given $20, and it stopped and slowed down at 16.
Oh, yeah.
And I said, are you kidding me? It took longer to put the last $4 in than the first 16.
Yeah. Some places I will not go and get gas because I know their pumps are slow.
Oh, man, I hate that. Sometimes there's something wrong with the pump, and it just pumps slow from the beginning. And they go, oh, no, I'm not doing this. And I'll stop it and go in and get a different one. And then, at least this, I mean, this wasn't one of those stations, I was really upset, where I had gas station TV to watch. You ever see this?
Yeah.
What is gas station TV?
Oh, you haven't seen
that
this?
No. That was actually the first time I ever saw was when we came back from Rodizio the first time.
Uh-huh.
And I stopped to get gas.
Up in Tannersville by us,
yeah,
right?
Up in Tannersville. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, yo, man, did you ever see this? I was just watching a hockey game on the gas pump.
As soon as you start, as soon as you flip it on and start gassing, the TV screen comes on and you're watching. It's like Entertainment Tonight.
I watched sports highlights, and then there was a trivia game, and then there was all sorts of stuff while you're pumping your gas.
In Tannersville.
Yeah.
Which one?
When you get off the 299.
Make a left. Get off 80 at Tannersville exit, make a left.
The one high on the hill, not the one down low. Not the one with the Burger King, the other one.
Yeah, the other one. So you make a left, and then you make a left into the gas station.
Oh, okay.
I
know where you're talking.
And you would think, how would I have time to play a trivia game? Well, if the thing stops at $16, and it's gonna, you got lots of time.
Yeah.
The first trivia question, how long do you think it's going to take you to gas your car up tonight?
I saw like three hockey game highlights, a trivia game. I had the weather, the full weather forecast, everything. It was great.
It's like, it's like a concert. It's almost like a headline news kind of thing, but it's all lots of entertainment, lots of sports, lots of weather.
And it's a monitor in the unit.
Yeah.
In the gas pump. Yeah.
Right above where the cost of the gas is.
Yep.
Can you pick what you want to watch or is it just automatic?
No, just go channels yet.
But, maybe if you buy more than $100 worth of gas, they'll let you pick your channel. I don't know.
I was surprised, though. It was pretty cool.
Technology.
Right? It's amazing. 2017, you can watch TV.
It also just goes to prove that we're just, it's the world's addiction to distraction.
Yeah, you can't get away from it.
You know?
We can't go 3 seconds without, it's collective ADD.
If you don't have your phone on you now and you're sitting in a doctor's office, oh my God, what do I do? Magazine's not good enough anymore.
Have you ever almost not made it to the bathroom because you were looking for something to take in there with you?
No.
Magazine, my phone.
That's not me. I was never one of those guys anyway. I mean, the phone goes in there now, but I was never one of those read on the toilet type of guys.
Do your business and get out.
Well, at my house, I have books that I'm in the middle of in every single bathroom.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I've been working on these three books for the last 4 years. Yeah, I try not to spend as much time in there as I used to. Yesterday, I watched a person back into a parking spot.
Okay.
And I said to myself, why are they doing this?
Why not? I do sometimes.
Yeah.
Why?
Do too.
It depends.
No. Not that it depends. Why? Why would you? It's easier to pull out.
It's easier to pull out because people are nuts.
Because instead of back, if you're,
you got to back one of the times, either when you're parking or when you're leaving. So what's the difference when you're backing?
Well,
I'd rather. It depends. Back in. I'd rather back in.
Yeah, or pull through.
Well, this
pull through is the best.
This gentleman
pull through.
You of course take a chance on killing somebody if somebody's pulling in head to head. But okay, I can see a pull through. But backing in, this gentleman, and I'll use the term loosely, from the great state of New York, according to his license plate, who you got to imagine doesn't do a lot of backing in New York.
No.
Probably not.
Although maybe he could have been from upstate. I don't know. He decided not to. He actually pulled in halfway, and then for whatever reason, he had a thought of something or his wife told him or whatever, decided to pull out and back
and
in.
Back in, yeah.
Which would have been fine had it not been for the Hyundai parked next to him and his inability to pull in straight.
Oh, no.
Yeah, don't do it if you can't.
So it became an insurance matter after that. And I was thinking to myself, why do you need to back in? Just pull into the freaking spot. Backing in is reserved for delivery trucks, ambulances, getaway cars.
But that's it. No, I back into certain places, man. It depends.
And with a truck the size of yours, you're taking a chance anyway.
Yeah, I know. Well, that's recently, because I don't know if you saw my tailgate. It looks like someone hit it or threw something at it. I got a big dent.
No.
On the passenger side, I got a nice big scrape and a dent.
Wow.
So now I'm starting to... I finally have a car I like. I've never really enjoyed any car I've had because I never had anything that was, like, nice.
Nope.
So now, here I am.
The ding gods, gotcha.
Yeah, here I am, and it's getting ruined. So now I'm parking, like, away from everyone.
Yep.
You know, I'm walking it. I don't care. Like,
well, did you see there's a couple park... Well, there's one, definitely one parking lot behind Starbucks off of Ann Street. You must pull head on. They will not allow you.
Oh, yeah. I have seen that sign. Yeah. Yes.
Must head, park must head on parking only. Yes.
That makes sense to me. You know, just if you can't back up, don't park here. Because you're going to have to back up when you leave. And backing into a spot is a lot harder than backing out of a spot. Yeah. Because there's nothing around you when you're backing out.
True.
It just totally depends on where the spot is and what's going on. And then that determines whether or not I'm going to back in or not.
My first car that I had when I was 17 years old was an old jalopy that my uncle gave me. And we spent the summer rebuilding the body and making it new, painting it and making it look fresh. And I had it for about 5 or 6 months. I loved the car. And maybe longer, 9, 10 months. And then the transmission went on it. And the first thing that happened in the transmission going was that it wouldn't go in reverse.
Ooh.
So now here I was driving a car that I had to be very careful what situation I got in myself. Twice I had to pay $25 each just to have somebody come and tow me out of a parking spot.
That sucks.
Now, if I was if the parking spot I was pulling into went down, then I would back into it. But I would have to use gravity to back into it.
Yeah.
You know, I'd have to kind of open the door, push my foot,
and then,
kind of glide it in carefully so I could pull out of it after. The third time, I loaned it to my mother. I said, she needed a car. Her car was in the shop. And I said, you can take my car, but remember, it doesn't have a reverse in it. So she got stuck in a weird situation behind somebody, and she had to actually wait until they pulled away. They were at a store or something like that and waited till they pulled away so she could go. And she called me and she said, I'm at Lee Miles. They're checking your car out. It's up on the lift. I said, what is it? She says, I'm finding out why this car doesn't go in reverse. And then she came back home and she said, I said, did you get it checked out? She says, yeah. I said, what was the problem? Why would it go in reverse? She said, the guy said it needs some work. She says, but it's not going in forward very well right now. She said, I think I saw the guy take something out of the transmission because he dropped the transmission pan. And she says, I think I saw him reach up and take some pin out of this and put it into his pocket. And then when he put it back together, she says, it doesn't go in like second or third gear properly right now.
Oh, that's great.
A week later, somebody else owned it. I saw my first car to a guy whose son was a mechanic. So he could replace the transmission. But, you know, I just see these cars backing in all over the place. Like, come on, backing in. Stop with the backing in. It's like an upside down donut in a bag. It's unnecessary. Let's take a break. We'll be back in a few minutes.
This is Jack Boyle for the Pike County Chamber of Commerce, inviting you to join with Neversink Media Group and share in the excitement of the 2017 Chamber Champions Awards Dinner, Friday, November 3rd at Silver Birches in Hawley. Be there as we honor businesses and individuals of excellence across Pike County, making a difference in economic development and quality of life. Award recipients include Safe Haven of Pike County, United Way, Greater Pike Community Foundation, Woodlock, DP Lures True Value Hardware, Business of the Year Key Food Marketplace of Milford, as well as individual recipients Amy Eisenberg, Matt Osterberg, PJ Wybell, Justin Genslinger, and recipient of the Lifetime Achievement Award, Davis R. Chan. Reserve now by calling 570-296-8700. That's 570-296-8700.
96.7 weather. Here's the Poconos pinpoint weather. Tonight's partly cloudy with a low of 38. Tomorrow, sunny all around with a high of 70. Tomorrow night, a moonlit sky with a low of 43. Tuesday's pleasant with plenty of sun and a high of 71. Tuesday night, a moonlit sky with a low of 49. By Wednesday, it's pleasant with plenty of sunshine and a high of 74. Thursday's mainly cloudy and warm with a high of 76. I'm Alex Rabb with the Pocono's most accurate pinpoint weather from the Pocono 96.7 Weather Tower.
Pocono 96.7.
You're listening to Inside Dr. Herman's Head every Sunday night starting at 7 o'clock right here on Pocono 96.7. And now, back to the good doctor.
All right, back on Dr. Herman's very, very last back with you.
Yeah, that's it.
This is our last show.
It is.
Yeah.
And you know what? Hold on. I got
10 minutes. You got a little something special for our last show?
Yeah, because we're graduating.
Because we're graduating.
We're graduating.
We're getting our broadcast diploma.
This is the Macho Man Randy Savage theme song.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. Hey, man, I'm watching videos of him right now. Is this place?
I'm watching it too. It's kind of awesome.
This is our finale show. You know what? That's another thing.
Yep.
When I was watching America's Got Talent, they said this is our finale show.
Well, if they
got a winner, it's over.
Yeah, but why do they say finale? Why does it get to be the final show? Our final show. Why do they make
final,
it French?
Because final's so final.
Finale sounds so much better.
But that's not our language. It's
every
not English.
Every show says it's season finale.
Yeah. Season finale or series finale of the series finale.
Yeah, but you know there's a next season coming. Now, if it's final show, it's like, that's it. Yeah. It's over.
There's no reason to use a foreign word in the middle of the sentence.
Listen, man.
My new dictate is that from now on, every English sentence has to have a foreign word in it. Whatever you want. And you can use a made-up foreign word if you want, like forte. That's not my forte. There's no word forte. It's fort.
It's not my fort, yeah.
Yeah. But forte.
But if you're talking musical language, you have forte.
That's true. There. Ah, good one.
See? You know,
that's
if
you're
talking music.
And you're not the musician. It's all right.
Forte in music means what?
It means get louder.
Get yes. louder?
Yeah.
The way you would in a, I don't know, finale?
Yeah. Crescendo.
What's the difference in a crescendo? Crescendo? Oh, there's forte is loud, and crescendo is building up to a forte.
And there's fortissimo. Supremely
you
loud.
Do, and you'll eat it.
That's right, man.
You clean it up, not me.
Bringing me back to my music theory.
For the last time, I'd like to remind people that Inside Dr. Herman's Head was brought to you by Thai Orchid. If you if you're a vegan, if you're a vegetarian, if you like the flesh, they got everything for you there.
The flesh.
If you're some people think being a vegetarian is disgusting.
The flesh.
Thai Orchid.
And the coconut ice cream.
Incredible. Oh, yes, yeah. Coconut ice cream. That's right. On top of champagne mangoes with sticky rice and black sticky rice.
Oh, so good.
And coconut milk on top. Yeah. Fantastic. Yes, we want to thank Thai Orchid for being our number one sponsor
our
the
sponsor
whole time that we were on
time.
The air.
Thank you.
Thank you, right to this good. Day. And they've been with us from the beginning. And we don't, not just because we get paid to say it. Oh, we don't get paid anything. Because this radio station gets paid. For us to say it, the food at Thai Orchid is incredible. So check it out. It's go down there like I do at least half a dozen times a week.
Yeah, jeez, I need to get back down there. Yeah. I need some tea.
It's good stuff. We should go after the show.
Yeah, I'm not today. But
you got a bottle of vino waiting.
I
for
got
you.
A bottle of wine at home. I'm going to celebrate. I'm going to listen to my Macho Man theme song, and I'm going to play Cuphead.
Cuphead. I saw Cuphead? You're listening to Cuphead. That looks pretty crazy.
Oh, man. It's a new video game that just came out that looks like a 1930s cartoon.
It looks very cool. Like,
it's amazing.
The cat kind of,
yes. Cool. It's freaking pulling. Well, I don't have any hair left. Pulling my beard hairs out over hairs. It. Yeah, it's hard.
So, and I would like to really honestly thank Melinda for being here the many times you have been.
Yes.
Well, thank you for having me.
You
I
are
enjoy it.
Our you, very, very favorite
you
guest.
You men are wonderful to be around.
Oh,
and we would
so
like
sweet.
To personally enjoy, invite you
yes.
to join us
yes.
When we start our podcast.
I would love
yes,
to be
yes, we're
going
to start a podcast. Definitely. So everyone needs to, if you like us and you've been listening to us, you need to pay attention to our Facebook page.
The Facebook page is Inside Dr. Herman Said. And if you don't, yes. if you haven't liked it already, not liked it, but followed it.
Yeah.
Please follow it so we can keep an eye on when our podcast comes
yeah,
to be.
Yeah, we will let you know. We have a call.
We do?
Yeah, let's do it.
Oh. Thank you for calling Inside Dr. Herman Said.
Hello, Dr. Herman.
Hello, Robert L.
I'm sorry that you're leaving.
We're sorry too. We feel bad about it. But it's what happened, and we think it's gonna, you know, everything for a reason. We're going to do a phenomenal podcast, and And we know that you're going to be there for us and listening and joining us on the podcast also, because you have been, just like I say, thank you to Melinda for being our number one guest. You have been our number one caller and our number one fan all along, you and June. And I want to personally thank you much, much more than I ever could.
Yes, you're very welcome.
But I know that you will be right there with us on our first podcast, which hopefully will be within the next month or two.
I don't know if I can do it, man. I don't know if I can have my parents listen to the podcast, because then I can't curse.
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Oh, they got the approval. That's nice. That's nice.
You better get it in writing.
You finally got all the writing.
The best of luck in your new endeavor.
Thank you very much, Bob. I appreciate that.
Later.
So, so we'll have our podcast up and running in the next month or two, hopefully.
Yeah. We need a little break. We need to recoup and come up with some new...
make some notes and...
new ideas and get our act together. And then we'll be back.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
And we'll let everybody know, like I said, Facebook page. Inside Dr. Herman's Head Facebook page.
Yes, we'll definitely be posting a lot more on that than we have been lately, actually.
Yeah, we need to.
But we... I think one of the things we have to do is we have to figure out what our funding is. We have to, you know, well, we're very lucky because we could be in the Philippines. Then we'd be screwed.
Yeah.
Did you hear what happened in the Philippines?
No, but just in general.
This guy, the president of the Philippines, his name is Rodrigo Duterte. Yes, Rodrigo Duterte. He's the guy that's running around killing people in the streets.
What?
For using drugs.
Oh, all right, nice.
Well, no. not just the drug pushers. Right, any user immediately gets killed.
Wow.
Okay?
Yeah,
any drug, anything, if you're smoking a joint, he could kill you in the street.
I got some friends that would probably love this guy.
He's very, very, very anti-drug and anti-crime, and he doesn't care. He kills everybody. A dictator of a degree that some people have never seen. He just defunded, check this out, the Philippines Human Rights Commission. Human Rights Commission, okay?
What?
The commission that oversees... human rights, the rights that you get just for being born, okay? They reduced the funding from $14.6 million a year to $20.
What?
$20?
What $20.
How?
To show that he wouldn't disband the commission, he gave them $20 a year as a stipend instead of $14.6 million.
So he can say, oh, we still have it.
Yes,
look, there's the $20.
Yeah, we still care about human rights.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Wow. Isn't that great? So we are going to have a bigger budget on our podcast than the Philippines Human Rights Commission gets.
Okay, yeah.
And I would gladly invite them to be on our first podcast, but they can't afford the ticket. Can't afford the ticket to be there.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. It's
I don't know
crazy.
Either.
But thank you very much for everybody for listening in. We had a blast doing the show. It was an experience for both of us. We both learned a lot doing it.
Yeah. And I definitely got to say I've learned a lot, you know.
Learned a lot about everything from broadcasting to people.
Exactly.
You know, and it's been great to bounce our ideas off each other, off our guests, off our callers.
And, you know, Dr. Herman and I got to eat some good food.
And, that's not going to change. That's not going to change. And anytime you miss us, if before the podcast starts, come on down to Tioca. We're probably going to be hanging around there.
And Rodizio, man.
Rodizio Steakhouse down in Allentown. Absolutely. Yep. Pedro says, come on down. We'll all have a meeting. M-E-A-T-I-N-G.
Yeah, that's not even a... That's meat coma. We get the meat sweats.
Get the meat sweats.
That's what I had after that. I was like, man, I got the meat sweats. Unreal.
Thank you very much. We here at Inside Dr. Herman's Head care for all of you much more than anybody on TV.
Or you think we do.
but then we've done our job.
No, we haven't sounded very caring.
As long as you think we care about you, we've done our job.
Believe us, we do love you and everybody that's called in and everybody that's cared to listen.
Have a phenomenal season. Have a phenomenal October. And eat all the kids' candy before they get to it.
Yes.
Save me some.
It's all about save you some. Some fried Oreos. Big Show.
Yo.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Thank you.
Peace out.
Peace.